Hey guys, as you may already know that it is quite easy to move data from Android to iPhone with the help of Move to iOS app. But will this Move to iOS app allow you to transfer data from Android to iPhone if you have already set up your iPhone and using it for a while now? Well, the answer is no. You will have to factory reset your iPhone in order to use the Move to iOS app, which is not that convenient as it seems. So, in this tutorial, I will show you a few ways to transfer data from Android to iPhone after the setup. Without further ado, let's get started. First, I'm going to show you how you can easily transfer data from Android to your iPhone anytime after the setup with the Phone Transfer Tool. It is available for Windows and Mac users. You can check the video description text for more info. After running the app on your PC, select Phone Transfer Mode, and inside the Phone Transfer Mode, click Phone to Phone option. The program will ask you to make Connector as default SMS app on your Android, so let's do that. This is temporary. After transferring your data to iPhone, you can make the Messages app your default SMS application again in just one click. You won't be able to transfer text messages from Android to iPhone without making Connector your default SMS app. Press the OK button and software will detect your Android and show it on its user interface. Now, let's connect the iPhone to the computer using the Lightning cable. You'll be able to transfer almost all the data that includes contacts, text messages, calendars, photos, and all types of media files from Android to iPhone after the setup. In order to keep the video short, I will only transfer text messages and contacts from my Android to my iPhone. Click the Start button and the software will start moving the data from Android to your iPhone. Here, software is reminding me to disable the messages syncing on my iPhone so that it can transfer text messages from Android to my iPhone. So let's do that. You need to go to Settings and open your Apple profile, then go to iCloud and turn off the messages syncing from there. Now, tap on Disable and Download Messages button. Click the OK button to proceed. Next, you need to turn off the Find My iPhone feature on your iPhone by going to Settings, your Apple profile, Find My. After turning off the Find My iPhone option, click the Retry button to proceed. Please note that you can re-enable these features after moving your data from Android to your iPhone. The whole process should take some time. The more data you have, the longer it will take to transfer everything from Android to your iPhone after you've completed the setup. You can disconnect your iPhone from your computer when Restore Completed Messages flashes on your computer screen. Now, let me quickly show you the content that I transferred from Android to my iPhone. As you can see, the tool has successfully transferred all the text messages from Android to my iPhone. The whole process is pretty quick and straightforward. Now, let's move to the next method. In this method, I will use an app called Shareit to transfer data from Android to iPhone after the setup is already done. This app is available on both App and Play Store for free. In order to use this app to transfer data between Android and iOS, your both devices should be on the same Wi-Fi network. You can link your Android and your iPhone to each other by just scanning a QR code. After linking both the devices, you can wirelessly transfer files such as music, photos, and videos from Android to iPhone. Unlike Phone Transfer Tool, you cannot transfer your text messages, contact list, and calendars with this app. Now I quickly transfer a few photos from Android to my iPhone to show you how it works. So here are the photos on my iPhone that I transferred from my Android. Did you notice how quick it was? That's it for now. So these are the few ways to move or transfer data from Android to iPhone after the initial setup without using Move to iOS app. If you found this video useful, then please don't forget to like it and share it with others. I'll see you soon with a new tutorial.